Good morning. It is always a privilege as a vice president, also as president of course, to have the opportunity to say a few words and try to set a certain tone for this conference. So let's say our title is quite clear, but our idea for this conference is for compassion, transformation, metaphysical, theosophical ideas into practical, useful ideas for suffering humanity. You see, it's quite a number of words, but I think that is what we try to do in the coming days. I think as ITC, we have two aims, two missions, two part of a missions. We have a short-term mission, and we have a long-term mission. And there are not apart. It is like cleaning your left and right hand that is going together. So by doing the one, you also work on the other one. And I think, and you can have a discussion over this, but I think that ITC, we have a responsibility to making the things known, yeah? And we have not, let's say, it is not our responsibility to make everybody a theosophist, because there is free will, there is everybody his own responsibility, but you can hold us responsible for the fact that the people outside the organizations don't know theosophy. So I think our duty is to make it known, and then people can make their own choice of they like to do something with it, if they like to step in it, to like study it, or just put it aside and go out with their life. But I have learned over the many years I'm now active in theosophy, is that the best way of demonstrating theosophy is not only speaking about it, but is living theosophy, being a living example. Show people that if you have problems in life, you can approach that problems and you can solve them. That is the best thing. You know, a couple of years ago, we stepped for the first time in the Mahatma letter. We were using that letter as one of our themes of a conference. And to me, that letter is the most modern way of description what our duty is. If you start reading that letter, it is so modern, it is so direct, it is so practical. And one of the key ideas in that Mahout Johan letter is the thing that it is time that theosophists should enter the arena. So that means we have to go out, we have to do something, we have to show something, not only study at home and speaking in small groups about it, but we have to demonstrate something. We have to popularize theosophy, not by doing concessions on the principle, but try to bring them in daily words, in daily examples, but also be able, if you see something in medical research, physics research, astronomical research, are you able to translate that ideas and discoveries back to the theosophical principles, and you can show that there is a main principle what in fact explain all this type of things. And then the transformational point of view is also something what we have to do. Sometimes we are like old Christian traditions. You can speak with each other by just saying key page 555, and everybody knows what you mean, but an outsider of course not. And if we use very theosophical terms, we can easily speak with each other, but outsiders need a little bit more words so that we can really come to an idea. Yeah, and the Mahout Johan write it in the idea that transform high metaphysical theosophical ideas into practical understandable ideas and searching for people searching for solutions. Now I have learned over the last part of months that solutions can be dangerous, that word. Some people think solutions means that you work out something and say to another one, this is the solution, this is the way you have to do it. This is not the way we like to work in this conference. We like to work out the theosophical principles and show the people how that laws work and integrate with each other. And then it is everybody's free will to see what direction he wants to go in a certain situation. Last year in Philadelphia, there was really a very big, let's say, a very great atmosphere, and also a need, let's try to do something more practical. All that lectures, very nice, very interesting, but we have to do something practical. And that work, that is what we have worked out in the Philadelphia Declaration, what is part of your program. And I'd like to emphasize just number one and five, yeah? Identifying the hot topics, what needs a solution for a theosophical perspective. And the other one is inspiring, encouraging, facilitate theosophical branches and organizations to enter the arena and to look for the answers. But answers are not full, let's say, ready answers. That means we have to bring the principles and everybody has to work it out for his own situation. So we have three topics. We have religion intolerance for today. We have depression and we have end of life for the other days. And we all have to address them from spiritual level, mental level, and physical level. Because if we are applying theosophy, we cannot be saying, okay, everything is on the spiritual, mental is not important, or spiritual and mental, and physical is not important. We all have a body, we all need a body, so far I can see, and we have all have to work. And all the three levels can give sometimes certain problems and challenging. So we have to deal. So we have to understand how that combination is working, and if we go for solutions, what are the consequences of all the three levels. And then, of course, we have to work over the different theosophical traditions. And that is something what gives everybody a big enhancement. I have really learned over the years that we're doing that. My first ITC conference was 2007. And working over the traditions gives an enrichment in understanding theosophy. Because quite often, if you are in a certain direction, you know how to speak with each other, you develop an own type of theosophical dictionary and understanding of the terms. And if you come across other people from other traditions, then they can help you just to put some questions on your table and you say, that is something I have to rethink about, because I was always thinking. And that is a rich moment. If you say, I was always thinking, then you are just on the edge to make a big step forward. Open up your mind, start rethinking, and see how it will fit. So by doing this, we can do the transformation and the implementation, and the transformation into the practical things in daily life, but also in daily languages. There's a big challenge. If I look what happens in the Netherlands and some other places, quite often we can give excellent presentations. But if you ask people coming in for the first time, what were you able to take from these lectures? Then I say that amount of information can be quite little, because we don't realize after a number of time that we're using so much theosophical terms without realizing that for other people it has no meaning at all and needs much more explanation. One of the things what we will do in this conference, and that is a real challenge because this approach, what we will do in the coming days, is totally new. We have never done before. And that is a type of training we have to do. It is a new field, we have to work together and so on. And you know, Dutch people like skating, and we have a saying in the Dutch that no skating without falling, yeah? Or we will make mistakes, for sure, yeah? And that mistakes we have to help each other by solving these mistakes. And giving an exchange, And keep in mind, another way of falling on the ice is not sharing your knowledge and your information. Because we are brotherhood, we are open, we know each other reasonably well, we can express and we should be exchange all the ideas we have, and also able to help another to correct and to understand it in a much better way. So not helping is also falling on ice. And that is what we try to avoid and we have to help each other with. Yep. Long-term mission is something else. The short one is I'm just speaking about for what we have to do in the coming days. The long-term is to support the work of the Lords of Compassion. Yeah? And then that means that we have to look to ourselves, not only able to translate it in daily words, but we also working on a personal development, and that we only can do with each other. Studying in Theosophy is only a first step. Living it is the main thing. Yeah? And then we should help in developing what I have called a new type of humanity. Yeah? A type of humanity what is able to think from the wisdom part of their thinking. Yeah? So that is an important thing, that long-term mission. And you will see that if we do the short-term, what we do in coming days, the long-term is something what, how do you say that, stay with us over the coming things, and that is what we take with us for the next year. What we have to realize, and that is of course a lot of discussion under theosophical organizations, what is the reason that not all the people in the world have interest in theosophy? And I think we have to realize that if we're thinking about spreading theosophy, we don't have to think in years, but in incarnations. Someone we inspire today will inspire others. Some we inspire today will only inspire others in their next incarnation. And it takes hundreds of years, 3,000 of years, at HPB seeing as a general average. So if you take the 3,000 as a point to start, then you can realize that we need a continuity in spreading theosophy for 3,000 years before we have addressed everybody. So that is a real long-term mission, what we have to do. But it's a very important one, because this is what will happening, and that is what we have to take in account, that we are not becoming, how do you say that, disappointed because we have only a certain amount of people and not a full stadium, 50,000 or even more. Yeah, that is a matter of what will happen on the long term. So I think this will be, I think, our mission for the coming days and for the coming incarnations. So let's see what we can do.